Hey guys, welcome back to Snowfog Outdoors. Before I get started on this video, I'd like to personally thank each and every one of you who checked out my last video and commented and went over and supported Dave and left him some awesome comments. And honestly, I didn't expect anything less from you guys. You're awesome. I know we can't change what happened, but maybe we can help him regain some of his courage and feeling good about himself to get back out and do what he loves to do. So, again, thank you very much from the bottom of my heart. It means a lot. I've been checking his video and comments, and I don't think he's replied yet. He may have by now. I don't know, but I'm sure he's a little overwhelmed. But you guys are just amazing for helping out and just showing them some love. So again, thank you. Okay, so this video, I want to take you on a little project with me. I have a replica patch knife that I bought off of Amazon. It's like a $10 knife. It's not expensive at all. And it came with like a $10 sheath. Not very well made at all. Not very functional for this kind of knife. And it, honestly, you know, for 10 bucks, 12 bucks, whatever it was, it's a very heavy knife. Very thick in the spine, has a very sharp 90 degree spine. It is stainless steel, but it has some awesome hardwood handles. And it, you know, it's a pretty good knife. For those of you that don't know what a patch knife is, it was a knife designed to cut the patches for the fabric for muzzle loading. So it was used back in the 1800s. Mountain men used them. Anyone that carried that type of rifle, the rifleman. And it would ride in a scabbard, either on their hunting bag or, you know, by their pockets. And I just wanted to make a little bit better of a sheath for it. Now, I could have sat down and just whipped a sheath together and it would have looked like something from the air, but I wanted something different. So I got on YouTube and I was looking around and I finally got into an area where they were making knife sheaths from rawhide. And rawhide is just basically the skin of the animal once the fur, the meat, and the fat is all scraped off. It's taken outside, it's stretched, and it dries. And when it dries, it's just a hard, you know, piece of hide. So what they do is they wet it, they form it to whatever they're making a sheath for. And they will take the raw hide and cut strips to make like a thong, like a leather thong type thing from it, and use it to stitch the sheath. And there's a variety of ways you can do the sheath and add on to it with softer leathers and blah, 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 blah. So pricing rawhide from like Tandy Leather wasn't too bad. It ranged from like $17 up to like $65. But I decided to do what they did online. Use a dog bone. Now, this is an all natural dog bone. I can't let my dog see these. I don't give them these rawhide bones because they're little dogs and they have a hard time digesting it. And this is it when it's hard. So what you do, rawhide to me is kind of like the kydex of the 1800s. It takes two different forms as far as getting it workable. Kydex you have to heat. It becomes pliable. You put your knife in it, you press it, wham, you got a knife sheath. Well, there's more work to it than that, but now rawhide, you soak in water, all these knots come out, you get a good size strip from it, put it on your bench. It's very pliable. I mean, it's like wet leather. I mean, if you've ever taken this out of your dog's mouth, you know it's malleable. Mold your knife, cut your strips for the thread, sew it up. Bless you. That's my dog. Wrap it up, stitch it, put whatever type of attachment you want on there. If you want a belt loop, if you want a neck carry. I think I'm going to go neck carry, as far as I know. And you let it dry. Now, as it's drying, you can form fit the knife to it by using clamps, you know, little blocks of wood. So we're going to take this. Are you okay? Yeah, wait. Yeah, you're fine. Just don't knock my tripod over. We're going to take it out. We're going to soak it in some warm water until it's workable. Then we're going to come back in here and we're going to make a sheath. So stick with me. All right, so we got her in the sink out here. I have warm water in there, just like a tepid temperature. But as you can see, it wants to float. So what I'll do is I'll take my favorite oatmeal bowl here. Put it on there like that and let her soak for a few hours. When it's nice and pliable, I'll bring it back and we'll start building a sheath. Stay tuned. Okay, so I've had the rawhide soaking in the sink overnight. So we're going to take it out and put it on this towel I have here to soak up all the excess moisture. Kind of wring it out a little bit. And it's real easy to untie the knots. Oh, it's got a little baby inside. And you don't want really want to work with this when it's soaking wet. You want it to be, you know, still pliable, but not sopping wet. My dog is down here just sniffing away. I'm sorry, buddy. But you can't eat my sheath. So we're just gonna get this dried up a little bit and then we'll take her into the workbench and get started. Okay, so I've got this pretty well dried up a bit. Now I'm gonna put a little disclaimer out there. I am not an expert. I am not a professional when it comes to making anything. Over the last year and a half, 2 years, everything I make, everything I do has been self-taught via YouTube. When I do make leather sheaths, it's usually just a thought in my head and it goes on the leather and I make a sheath. If it's a special kind of sheath or a special kind of knife, I will do a template just because I'm using veg tan leather and I don't want to waste it. If I'm making one out of scrap leather, I still don't want to waste it, but rarely will I ever do a template. So right now I can tell you that I have exactly $3 invested in this rawhide, and that's getting two bones for $3, and that is going to be the extent of the materials for the sheath, because I'm going to make the leather lacing out of the rawhide, and the only leather making tool you're really going to need is something to punch the lacing holes with. This is not going to be a stitched sheath. It's going to be laced. You'll probably, want a ruler. Like I said, a punching tool, a pen or a pencil. I have both because I'm not sure if pencil will show up on that. Something really sharp to cut your leather with, not your letter, or a pair of scissors. And of course, your knife. I'm also going to use a lacing needle to pull that rawhide through. It's just a special needle that opens up right there. And you put your lace in there and snap it shut. All right, so let's see what we got here. Going to take the big piece first, which is about, 24 inches long. And I want to see which end I want to use. I'm not going to use this whole piece, obviously. And the good thing about working with the rawhide is you don't have to rush through the project. I mean, if it starts to dry up on you and get stiff, you can always spray it down with water, or you can just re-soak it and continue on. This is a little bit thicker, actually, than what I was expecting. So let's see how far I want my knife in there. Make sure, because this is a very narrow piece. I just want to make sure I have enough. This not gotta be nothing fancy, folks. Oh yeah, I got plenty of room. Now the ones I watched online on YouTube did not make a welt. So I've been thinking, to welt or not to welt. But I think the way I'm gonna lace this, I'm not really gonna need a welt. So here's the tip of my knife right here. Right there. So I think I want to just draw a line there like that where the tip, can you see that? Where the tip of my knife is. And this stretches really good. It's really easy to work with so far. I'm not jinxing myself. Now, here's the end. Here's the end, not the end, but the blade itself. So, I think I want to go about, oh, that's the widest, maybe a half an inch right up to about here, so I can lace it. And I'll show you what I'm doing here in a minute. Just want to get this marked out. Now my pen doesn't want to write. Pencil maybe? Oh yeah, I didn't think that was gonna work. Let's locate the tip again. Right there. So actually, my markings aren't the best, but I just marked out the outline of the blade, and now I'm going to cut it. So I'll bring you right back. I'm just cutting it with scissors, just straight across. All right. Now, depending on what type of knife you're going to make this for, you might want to put a little saran wrap over this. This is stainless steel. So I'm not really all that terribly worried about it. All right, that's not too bad. Not too bad at all. Just wanted to get the right piece to work with here. Okay, let me mark this out and we'll come right back. I wasn't going to put you through the pain and torture of me trying to mark on this wet rawhide. I just figured it out. It's like working with pie dough. But you can see some of the markings I got on there. I wasn't going to put you through that torture test of me outlining this and no. But you get the basic idea of it. It just comes out to be the shape of a sheath. Very easy to do. And the good thing about working with this, in the condition that it's in, it's very, very stretchable. Unlike most leathers, if you've worked with veg tan, you know you can't stretch it. I mean, you can a little bit when it's wet, when you're wet molding, but not all that great. So now I have to decide. Wipe my knife off. Yeah, you'd probably want a saran wrap, a carbon steel knife. That would be my suggestion. Do or do I not want a welt? Now, I know all you leather guys and girls out there are saying, oh, you got to have a welt or the knife is going to slice through the stitches. And you're right. But I can replace those stitches again. You know what I mean? And it's not like I'm going to be able to glue this in place at all because of it being so wet. So that presents another problem. I don't know. I wish I could get your guys' opinion if I should welt it or not. I'm thinking no, because after this is done, I think I might just want to do another covering with leather. All right. All right, let me think on this. I'll bring you back. Getting down to the last of our lacing holes here. I'll tell you, trying to hold that welt into place was not fun. I really need some new cutters on my puncher here. All right, I think that'll be good, and I'll have a little drain hole there. So, there's our holes to lace. Now, I'm seriously thinking about maybe doing a belt loop. But I don't believe I am. Because I don't want to wear it on my belt. I want it to be a neck carry. So, we can incorporate that up here somewhere. Or I can make a loop after it's dry. But I want to show you one quick thing here. Let me move you down a little bit so you can actually see. I was thinking of maybe, not necessarily this piece of leather, but putting a piece of leather on it somehow. I don't know. I have to wait till it's done. So, let me set this over here. And we're going to cut our lacing. It's just basically cutting a continual strip. Probably just a little bit wider than a quarter of an inch, I would say. Oh, sorry, Ted. I just stepped on your paw. All right, let's see here.